believe the quick wit of comedian Jeff Wayne.
Hey, tonight's comic got his nickname from a couple of guys that are pretty decent in comedy. He got it from Billy Crystal and Robin Williams. That shows you the circles that he travels in. He's toured all over the world. He's appeared on many TV and radio shows. His comedy CDs are heard on Sirius XM, and his dry bar comedy special is called Big Daddy Kicks It. I want you to welcome a great guy and a very funny guy, Jeff Big Daddy Wayne.
Big Daddy's here. Oh, and I'm glad to be here. My name is Jeff Wayne. I'm originally from Newport, Kentucky. I moved to Los Angeles to become a big star, and here I am in Hendersonville. And I'll take it! Flew in from L.A., and of course, the flights today are crazy. Everybody in their masks. The plane is just crammed with people, and I'm sitting on the aisle with a mother at the window and her little six-year-old boy in between us. This kid is up and down, in and out, up and down, running up and down the aisles, in and out. And after a few hours, her mother turned and said, I hope my son isn't bothering you. I said, no, but I wish he'd go play outside. Now, let me tell you, I am proud to be from Newport, Kentucky. I'm proud to be from Newport, I'm proud to be from Kentucky, and I'm proud to be white trash. We are the world's last oppressed minority. I want you to think about that. Any other group of people, you call them a name, you're a racist, you're a bigot, or you're insensitive, but you can say whatever you want about white trash, nobody cares. Not even white trash. Do white trash lives matter? They don't care. And you won't hear that on Colbert. So I've got some good news for you. I've started dating again. I was married many years. We divorced, remarried. I wanted my house back. Unfortunately, we divorced again, and I just dedicated my life to raising the kids and being a good comedian. But a few months ago, I said, it's time for romance. Time to date. And I met a lady who was very attractive, personable, age-appropriate. Took her out to dinner. Before we even order anything, she goes, okay, before we start, I have to ask you a question. And you got to be totally honest, because our whole relationship will depend on it. And I'm thinking, this isn't good. This isn't. But I try to be a nice guy. So what's the question? She said, okay, now just be honest. What's your spirit animal? I said, what are you talking about? She said, and each one of us is a spirit animal. It's what we really are. It's wild. It's free. It could be a zebra or a gazelle or an elk. What's your spirit animal? You know, us guys may not be very good at relationships, but we know crazy when we hear it. So I thought I would shift things around. I said, what's your spirit animal? She said, I'm an Arctic fox. I'm white and fluffy. I have little black eyes, and I dart across the snow. And I'm thinking, oh, my. She said, now think hard. What is your spirit animal? I said, I'm a dung beetle. She said, that's not even an animal. It's an insect. I said, well, I'm still evolving. I'm evolving from the slime. It's that Darwin thing, you know. It was all over right there. But it makes me think, what is happening in the world? You're talking about education, right? In LA, we have what's called feel-good education. Theory is you don't fail the students, you don't hurt their self-esteem. What's the result? A bunch of stupid people that feel good about themselves. Joey, what's 2 plus 2? 3? You're so close, Joey. Someday, Joey, you'll be an airline pilot. I was doing a show a couple years ago at a college. This is how they're changing our language. You know they're changing our language. I told a joke. I said, my grandma's going deaf. We can't afford a hearing aid, so we just stopped talking to her. Lady stopped me and said, the term is no longer deaf, it's hearing impaired. I said, doesn't matter what you say, she ain't going to hear it. Look, All the language is supposed to be sensitive now. We used to use the term illegal alien. It was supposed to establish that person's legitimacy and, you know, whether they're an alien or an illegal alien. Suddenly that's racist. It's insensitive. So now they're undocumented workers. Pretty soon burglars will be unwelcome house guests. Maybe it's the schools. When I was a kid one time, this teacher, she didn't like me. I was a class clown. She said, "You're stupid. You should never tell a child they're stupid." And she said, "I'll prove you're stupid. What's closer, the moon or Paris?" I said, "The moon." She said, "How do you figure?" I said, "I look out the window at night. I can see the moon. I don't see Paris." And before I finish, and we find out what the governor's spirit animal is, the big news from Los Angeles is the media is all aglow and happy that the white people will soon be the minority and the minorities will be the majority. And I have friends that say, "How do you feel about being a minority?" I said, "Great, I'll have some rights." God bless you, Merry Christmas, and thank you. Thank you, Tommy.
Oh, that's great. Absolutely wonderful.
So yeah, what?
Great having you here.
What is your spirit animal? Because I know you're thinking of it.
It's probably the unicorn. It's something that doesn't exist. Therefore.
Well, you got me with that one.
There you go. Hey, if you want to find out how you can see our book, Jeff Big Daddy Wayne, and get his comedy CDs and see his hilarious dry bar comedy special, go to Huckabee.tv. We have a connection right to Jeff, and you're going to want it. What a great time. Give him a big hand, everybody.
Thank you.
Wayne.
Thank you.